Massive trees blocked almost all light from the moon. An eerie silence enveloped Teresa. She cautiously ventured onwards.
Teresa, one foot in front of the other. A plant from Inferno. I wonder how it will respond to my magic. My magic feels more powerful than before. Could it be the brace?
Looking into the dark underbrush, Teresa could not shake the feeling that someone was looking back. As the wind rustled the leaves, it sounded just like a rasping voice whispered in her ear.
I can't turn back now. I'm going to become a witch and save Mummy.
Thank you.
was that? Must have been a rabbit or something. Right, Cheshire? Is someone out there?
Ceresa could not shake the feeling she was being watched.
Is someone there? Show yourself!
And then, as if to answer... These were fairies, nefarious creatures who ensnared. This time there was nowhere to run.
Please, please walk this time. Batai Vatorzu!
Even after the summoning circle had faded away, no one had answered her call.
I did everything right!
The fairies resumed their sinister mission. All at once, they jumped at Ceresa, weapons poised to strike. She shut her eyes tight and prepared for the worst. A moment passed. And then...
What? Who are you?
Chomp!
That beast, as dark as a moonless night, had it all been a dream?
You don't think... Could that have been...
But before Ceresa could finish her question... From its gaping maw, extending ear to ear, fell a drop...
Wait, did I manage to summon a demon that has now possessed Cheshire?
As if in reply, the beast growled and bared its blood-red fangs. Just as Ceresa feared, a demon had indeed possessed her beloved stuffed cat. The creature had desperately sought a medium in order to survive in our world, in lieu of... Looking around, the demon's eyes found Ceresa. It let out a low growl. After her initial terror, Ceresa realized that she was able to understand what the demon was...
You want me to return you to Inferno? Now, how would one go about doing that?
Ceresa had her hands full calling a demon to this world. She hadn't even begun to study the spell to send them. Ceresa once again, heard the demon's words, this time even more clearly. Send me back! Send me back! The demon's rage and out of patience, he pounced. Claws like daggers descended on Ceresa. But what if we hear? The demon had stopped cold. As if bound by an invisible force, no matter how he struggled, he was unable to touch Ceresa.
Calm down! You're going to burst a seam! Don't worry, I'll send you home. I'm on my way to get a fantastic power! With that, sending you back should be a piece of cake.
Giving up his attack, the demon turned his attention elsewhere. Intrigued but a little scared, Ceresa decided to follow a bit behind. The demon ran through the forest, searching for a way home. The demon slashed with his razor-sharp claws. But something felt off. His power seemed to escape him, slowly but surely.
What's wrong?
The demon bared his fangs.
Are you sick? Or hungry, perhaps?
As Ceresa approached, the demon felt the strength return to his body. In an instant, he felt right. His body was linked to Ceresa by powerful magic. Moving away from her robbed it of its energy.
What's that? I need to stay close to you? I've never heard of a spell like this before.
How do you plan on getting me back to Inferno?
The demon demanded.
We first need to find a white...
Leave it to me.
I'm Ceresa. What's your name?
I have no...
You don't have a name? May I call you Cheshire? That's the name of the stuffed cat you decided to borrow after all. Well, I need to call you something. If you're going to make a fuss about it, why don't you just find a new body? Fine! I'll just call you whatever I please.
And so these strange companions set off in search of the White Wolf. What mysteries await in Avalon Forest? The demons seemed to have calmed down. Remembering that he could not touch her, Ceresa breathed a sigh of relief. The pungent scent tickled Ceresa's nose. It was rosemary, often used to ward off evil spirits. As soon as the scent reached Cheshire, he pulled away, face scrunched up in disgust. It looked like demons could not stand being anywhere near the flower. This was quite a pickle, but Ceresa knew how to get by without a scratch.
Cheshire, I've got it tied down! Finish it!
at once, Cheshire's body shrunk to its original cuddly form.
Cheshire!
Cereza ran to pick up Cheshire and held him tightly to...
Release me at once!
Even in this form, the demon did not seem happy about being cut...
Just hold still, will you? While you're small, you can't walk on your own, right? I'll carry you until you can... Not having a massive demon breathing down my neck will make it easier for me to calm down too.
While far from pleased about being treated like a stuffed animal, the demon had no choice but to swallow his pride.
Even with you in there, Cheshire still weighs the same as before. Rosemary. Cheshire, I'll toss you up there. See if there's a way forward.
Yeah!
A chest. Did the fairies make this? I wonder what's inside. Yes! What have we here?
There were signs that a witch had set up camp here.
Perhaps I'm not the first witch to enter this forest. Oh well, it means we've got a place to rest. Look what we have here! Let's take a break.
Before them stood a large wolf. Its snow-white fur shone, pale silver in the moonlight.
Avalon Forest, the white wolf guide you.
Seresa was captivated by the wolf. It seemed almost not of this world.
Thank you.
The world before Ceresa seemed to warp and bend. She blinked hard, to no avail. Could this be a fairy trick? Cheshire was losing patience with his hesitant companion.
Come on! We've still got that wolf to catch!
I'm getting ready. Just give me a second.
As soon as she took a step inside, she felt as if the breath had frozen in her chest. All around her were sights strange and terrible, as if she had been dragged into a waking nightmare.
I'm fine. It takes more than this to scare me. My way in here.
Suddenly, Ceresa's magic brace began to glow. What could it be? The light from the brace revealed things Ceresa was unable to see before. A sight unlike anything either had seen before.
Cheshire, I have a feeling we're not in Avalon anymore.
Cheshire, over here!
is this fairy treasure? They'd be hopping mad if I stole it.
Thank you.
You're the boy from my dream.
Center of forest. Waiting. Help me. Power.
Okay. I just need to follow the white wolf.
Destroy all elemental cores. You can do it. Follow White Wolf.